We're in the descent into Barcelona, on our way down to flight level 90. At around this point of the flight, 10,000 feet, we turn on the seatbelt signs and instruct the cabin crew to secure the cabin for landing. Cabin crew, prepare the cabin for landing.
Jetliner 488, expect ILS Zulu runway 24 right.
ILS Zulu runway 24 right, Jetliner 488. ATC have told us that we're going to land on runway 24 right by performing the ILS Zulu approach. Enter this into the FMGC by clicking Flight Plan to display our current routing. Next, click on the button next to LEBL, the ICAO code for Barcelona, written in white. Next, click the top left button where it says Arrival. This brings up a list of all the available arrivals in the navigation database. Now, use the up arrow to scroll through the list of approaches until you find ILS 24 right Zulu. Click on it once you find it, being careful to select the correct approach. After selecting the approach, you see it displayed in yellow on the ND. Press Insert to activate this approach. Once below 10,000 feet, our 250 knots speed restriction applies. Select a speed of 250 knots.
Jetliner 488, descend altitude 4,000 feet, QNH 1010.
Descending to altitude 4,000 feet, QNH 1010, Jetliner 488. Set 4,000 in the alt window on the FCU and pull for open descent. Just like switching the altimeters to standard during the climb into the flight levels, we're now switching back to altitudes. Push the barrow knob and set a QNH of 1010. Great, now we're back to using altitudes for our height reference.
Jetliner 488, direct to Tebla.
Direct Tebla, Jetliner 488. Press direct on the FMGC and enter Tebla as our direct to waypoint. You can type Tebla in directly or scroll through the list to find it, pressing insert. Good, this cuts out most of the arrival and gives us a better idea of our distance remaining. It's pretty grey outside, turn on the landing lights to make us easier to see.
Jetliner 488, speed 210.
Speed 210, Jetliner 488. Before landing, we use the FMGC to activate the approach phase, which allows the FMGC to control our speed on final approach. The approach phase will activate automatically when we reach the decel point on the ND, or you can activate it manually. let's talk about how we decelerate and configure the aircraft for landing. On the PFT speed tape, notice the amber coloured equals sign. This represents the maximum speed for the next stage of flaps, called VFE next. Before extending flaps, we make sure that our speed is below VFE next, otherwise we'll overspeed the flaps. A typical deceleration profile for the A320 begins with extending flaps 1 and setting a speed of 180 knots. Once we're on the approach, we'll extend flaps 2 and take 160 knots. Let's start configuring. Check your speed is below VFE next on the PFD and select flaps 1. We can get a big boost in lift from the flaps, known as ballooning, but allow the autopilot to take care of this. And now select 180 knots.
Jetliner 488, descend altitude 3,000 feet.
Descending 3,000 feet, Jetliner 488.
Jetliner 488, turn right, heading 170.
Right heading 170, Jetliner 488. Set a heading of 170 in the FCU and pull to select. For this approach, we're going to follow the ILS. Before doing so, we need to ensure that the correct ILS is being displayed. Please check that the ILS ident Bravo Charlie Alpha is displayed at the bottom left of the PFD, which is the correct ILS for runway 24 right. If not, you have the wrong approach selected in the FMGC, which will need changing right away.
Jetliner 488, cleared ILS approach, runway 24 right.
Cleared ILS approach, runway 24 right, Jetliner 488. Now that we're cleared for the approach, arm the approach mode by pushing the approach button on the FCU. Now the autopilot is ready to capture and follow the localizer and glide slope. Lock mode has engaged, which will capture the localizer. Glide slope mode captures and descends down the glide slope. Now extend flaps 2. And bring us back to 160 knots. Good. Gear down. Now that the gear is down, arm the spoilers. Now set flaps 3. And finally, flaps full. Now push the speed knob for managed speed. The speed target is now magenta, indicating we're in managed speed, giving us our target approach speed.
Jetliner 488 cleared to land runway 24 right. Wind 210 at 16.
Cleared to land runway 24 right, Jetliner 488. Landing checklist. Cabin secured for landing. Auto thrust speed. Go around altitude 3000 set. ECAM memo, land no blue. Landing checklist complete. Now disengage the autopilot and fly manually. Now fly us down to the runway visually. At 50 feet, look to the far end of the runway. Then smoothly raise the nose a little to reduce our descent rate and move the thrust levers to idle. After touchdown, allow the nose to gently lower onto the center line. Auto brake low is selected, which will handle the braking until we're nearly at taxi speed. We'll exit to the right. Look to the end, flare, and thrust idle.
40, 30, 20, retire.
Allow the nose to lower smoothly. Passing 70 knots, press the brake pedals to disengage the auto brake. Slow us down to a taxi speed below 30 knots. take one of the exits to the right. Well done. When we return, we'll look at how to taxi in after arrival, parking, and shutdown.